Good day, fellow investors. Welcome to the stock market news with a long-term fundamental twist. We are in the midst of earnings season, so today we're going to discuss earnings from a long-term perspective. Earnings are crucial, perhaps the most important, not perhaps, the most important factor when it comes to your investment returns. Your investment returns, as Buffett always says, will be perfectly correlated with the underlying performance of the business, thus earnings. So in this video, I really want to focus on the importance of earnings, on the current trend in earnings, on valuations, what is the perspective that we can get now on earnings in order to see what will be long-term investment returns from the current point. That's what matters, not what matters in the past, not what happened in the past. And then see what are the impacts, the factors impacting those earnings, how are those going to affect your long-term investment outcomes. Let's start. So if you look at the importance of earnings, the long-term correlation between share prices and earnings per share is extremely strong. Warren Buffett says it's perfectly correlated. Well, statistically, not perfectly, but you get the point with this picture. The white line is the S&P 500 trailing 12 months earnings per share, and the blue line is the S&P 500. There are some deviations here and there, but over the long term, it's practically a straight correlating line. The better earnings are, the better are your returns. There can be sometimes of exuberance, sometimes of less exuberance, but that's pretty much it. And we now have to see, okay, what's next? This has been over the last 70 years, and we have to see, okay, where we are now and what's next? What do valuations say? What do trends, what do margins say? And by the end of this video, you will get a great picture about where are earnings going, what's influencing earnings, and what you can do about that in respect to your portfolios and how your portfolio is structured for what is happening. The most important things we are going to discuss are margins, that earnings are actually in a recession, real reported and adjusted earnings, big differences there, financial engineering and earnings, and then US and global earnings. Let's immediately start with margins. It is very likely that margins will return to the mean. What does that mean? Well, the higher the margins, in this case, the net profit margin, the higher are earnings, the higher are stock prices. However, over the past 50, 70 years, on average, earnings have been 6 to 8% of gross domestic product, of GDP. Currently, we are at 10%, and over the last 10 years, thanks to low interest rates, thanks to lower taxes, it has been even above 10%. Buffett always says that earnings, corporate earnings, should be between 6 and 8% of GDP. As GDP growth will be 2%, it's likely that earnings will be those that revert to the mean and that earnings margins will be lower. Just one example of how this works. During the last 2 years, for the first time over a very long period of time, air quality in the US has decreased. This means that pollution is higher, health will be affected, 10,000 deaths are expected, more 10,000 deaths per year due to quality of air. And if companies save on air quality, their earnings are higher. This must change, this will probably change in the future. And therefore, this is just one thing that puts pressure on earnings. Not to mention higher taxes, probably higher wages in the future because wages didn't grow much in the past. This is something to keep in mind for long-term investors. We are really in a Goldilocks period for margins and therefore earnings. And we already see the impact of those things slowly. Late part of economic cycle, economic growth slowing down. And you see that those margins have been contracting a little bit. You see 2018, tax benefit, lower corporate taxes that really pushed margins higher. But now, after that boom, what will be the next thing pushing earnings higher, margins higher? We don't know. And therefore, earnings are a little bit subdued and they are actually already in a recession. So apart from the possible mean reversion of margins, for the last three quarters, earnings really didn't grow at all. We have seen negative earnings growth. Didn't affect stocks. I would be in panic if I would see negative earnings growth on aggregate. But stocks keep pushing higher, keep going higher, keep staying above 3,000 for the S&P 500. But the earnings picture, which is crucial when it comes to long-term investing, isn't good at all. And also analysts have been adjusting their estimates, and they have really reduced their estimates for 2020. Those are always very positive estimates at first, and then they are adjusted to the negative. But still, we see a negative trend, and we haven't seen a recession yet. So in combination of a recession in 2020, 2021, who knows when it might happen, it could be very, very detrimental for stocks. And there are other forces impacting buybacks, margins, earnings that we'll discuss in a moment. But this is just one side of earnings. The real earnings reported, there are real earnings reported and financial earnings, financial engineered earnings. The National Income and Profit Accounts Association calculates earnings in relation to GDP. And you can see how the black line here, over the past 10 years, earnings in relation to GDP, which means that the real productivity, the real earnings capacity of companies didn't grow at all. The black line is a flat line. Then you have S&P 500 trailing earnings per share. Those started growing in 2015 to 2019 and then flattened again. But that's not because there was actually some growth, just because of financial engineering through buybacks and taxes. So if you look at this from an objective perspective, okay, is the economy doing really better? Beyond financial engineering, there is little evidence that corporate America is as strong as it appears. If you look at the blue line, stocks don't care about anything. Interest rates are going lower, therefore stock prices go to the moon and everything is much more valuable. However, the discrepancy in earnings is something to be very, very, very worried about. And I think that the next stock market crash will come due to earnings. If we remove the tax benefit, remove engineering based on debt that leads to buybacks, earnings didn't go anywhere. Talking about buybacks, look at the extreme amount of buybacks during 2018 and 2019. It's crazy how much buybacks have been down. 800 billion on a 30 trillion market capitalization. So that's a little bit less than 3% per year of the market capitalization is bought back by companies themselves. So companies are crazily investing your money into their own stocks. This, of course, helps earnings a little bit, but I wonder whether the cost is justifiable, whether the cost of stocks now is justifiable to do buybacks. Wouldn't we all be better if they would simply pay out as dividends and then let us decide what to do with the money, not push buybacks at historical highs? Why didn't they do so much buybacks in 2009 when the S&P 500 was a real bargain? So this is the story. Earnings matter, and therefore we have to carefully watch them. Another thing that we have to really look at, and perhaps the most important things, are valuations. What are we paying? What's the price now for the earnings, the price to earnings ratio? Because apart from the correlation with earnings, stock market returns are correlated to the valuation, to the price you're paying for those earnings. And that paints a perfect picture to what we already have been discussing. S&P 500 earnings, normal earnings, not adjusted for whatever they are adjusting every year, are 135 points. And they haven't been growing that much since 2007, approximately over the last 30 years, 2% per year. And that is the long-term trend. Ups and downs, taxes have helped a bit, but it's not miracles. If we look at the price earnings ratio, it's 22.36. This translates into an earnings yield. So what are the businesses earning? If I buy the S&P 500 at $3,000, let's say dollars, what is my earnings yield? What are those businesses giving back? Those businesses are giving you 4.47% in earnings. But keep in mind, this 4.47% is at historically high margin levels, so those margins will probably revert to the mean, at historically high buybacks where companies are pushing those stock prices up, up, and up, and at historically high earnings in the late part of the cycle. So it's very likely that those earnings will revert to the mean, the margins, the trend will revert. We might see economic slowdown, which we are already seeing globally, Germany, China slowing down a little bit. So the picture is very negative, and this 4.47% is the maximum. So the most likely option is the way down, not more up like prices are suggesting. Valuations are suggesting stock prices will go higher and higher because everybody's betting that interest rates will go lower. I wouldn't bet. I would base my investment on the long-term trend. Earnings are correlated to investment returns. Ups and downs, short-term, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, but that's something very risky to do. And then if we look at the connection with the cyclically adjusted price-earnings ratio that takes 10 years of earnings into account, average 10-year earnings, and long-term returns, the CAPE ratio is now at 30, and if we look at the expected returns over the long term, over the next 15 years, you can expect 3-5%, not more, from investing. This is the truth about earnings, plus there could be ups and downs, and the trajectory where earnings could lead over the next 10 years is unfortunately down. If that happens, if earnings start to matter again, when the financial engineering power stops, and at some point it will stop, a lot of investors will be in for a big, big, nasty surprise. So when you see that baby boomers might have to start selling stocks, and now they are selling just a little bit, the S&P 500 goes up, but in panic, they know that, okay, I need that money in the next 5-10 years. There might be a real crash into selling stocks to go to safety. When that happens, and if it is combined with low earnings, low cash flows for companies, combined with a recession, which means there cannot be buybacks at the scale those are pushing stock prices higher now, then you have really a spiral that might look very, very badly when it comes to investing. We don't know when it might happen. We don't know how it will develop. Will it be a sharp drop, a slow drop? Will it be zero returns over the next 10 years? So the only thing we can do is focus on those fundamentals, find businesses that will likely grow earnings over time, that are fairly priced, that have a competitive advantage. And that's what I always do. This video was to put things into perspective, how important are earnings, and then what I focus, and you'll see in the next videos about the stocks we analyze, also sharing something from my research platform, I really focus on those earnings, and I try to find those earnings that will go stronger, stronger, and stronger over the next 10-20 years, no matter the short-term fears of this case, financial engineering, stopping, recession, or something like that. We have to find businesses that overcome short-term factors, short-term impacts. Just another chart here. American companies out-earn the world. So it's very interesting how it's different economies, different scales, and it might be questionable whether this will be the case also in the future. America did really well over the past 30, 40, 50, 70 years. Perhaps the world will do even better in the future. We will see. To conclude, the high valuations suppose optimism that earnings will continue to grow in the future. And if we look at valuations, at earnings, at margins, at fundamentals, at everything, at the economy, at the late stage of the economy, it's unlikely that earnings will continue to grow how it was the case due to financial engineering in the past. Interest rates are very low. They go low, but that can go lower, but that's not an impact on earnings on businesses. So We will see what happens. I try to focus on businesses, business earnings, looking at hundreds, thousands of businesses to find those few businesses that have a competitive advantage no matter what, and that give me earnings returns. Over the next 10, 20, 30 years, I know that earnings win. Therefore, it's crucial to focus on those earnings and see how your portfolio is doing on that perspective, on the earnings perspective. That is what is the key when it comes to your long-term investment returns. Check my stock market research platform for my businesses, for my portfolios, for my research. Perhaps it fits you, perhaps not. Subscribe to the channel for more fundamental investing. The book lottery is still on, so subscribe to the newsletter in the link below, and I'll randomly pick 50 of you to deliver the book. Thank you for watching, looking forward to your comments, and I'll see you in the next video.